And we're back. Ole, ole. Dreidel, 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 right? Alright. Oh, yeah. Okay, we're back. And this is part two. Of course, you know, I'm not doing any fancy editing. I'm just going to one part, and go, or leave one part, go to another. Just, you know, just because. I just, you know, try to get to the point of just doing the updates without making it sound so fancy. But, you know, I just figure, what the heck. This next one, I got from Brendan Mitchell as well, aka Wet Movie One, and I think, if not mistaken, I don't think he bought it just recently, but I think this is the one of the first movies that he showed in his original update. Brendan, if I'm right, let me know. Halloween, the two disc special edition, because I remember I watched your first video that you put together, you know, your first DVD update that you say was like boring crap, but you know, I do believe it started like a legacy. I mean, you definitely know what you're doing, that's for sure. You know, guys like me, I'm still learning the trade of the game, I guess. But if this looks familiar, like it was probably your first collection DVD update. So anyway, it's the Halloween 2 disc edition. I saw a little bit in theaters, a little bit on the internet. I haven't watched it yet, but I will. And I want to thank Brendan Mitchell for sending these two DVDs, the Pick of Destiny and Halloween, the original, or, you know, the unrated edition. You know, I appreciate it, and just adds more to the collection, I guess. Now, a couple of these I bought maybe a month ago. This one here, you know, if you don't have this movie in your collection, you know, something wrong with you. I had the original version of this, you know, when Warner Bros. Did the Snapcase stuff, but they just released like a month or so ago, or back in September, they released the 20th anniversary edition of this movie. And you figure, I'm kind of disappointed a little bit because I thought they'd have more special features. And I'm talking about the Michael Keaton classic Beetlejuice. And the cool thing about this is it has the little 3D thing here, you know, which is kind of neat. But for special features, it has, okay, it has the three hilarious episodes from the trilogy, or from the cartoon, and which hopefully will come out on DVD someday. But it also has two trailers. It has the original Beetlejuice trailer, and it has Pee Wee's Big Adventure. And then it has a music-only track, too, as well. But and that's it. That's all the features. Well, you know, I mean, it didn't cost that much for me to buy. I'll give you that. I mean, it only cost maybe $13-14 at Walmart. So no big deal. I mean, I'd pay $25 for it if I had to. I do love Beetlejuice, you know. But I'm just a little disappointed. You figure, you know, they would have a little bit more stuff to talk about, like a documentary or something like that, you know. I mean, when I first saw the cover of what it was going to look like, or even heard that they were going to release a 20th edition of Beetlejuice, was Cool Duder's form that he has, that he was talking about that, or, you know, announcing that. But, you know, I thought there'd be more special features, but oh well, who knows. But the fact that they re-released their DVD and added the cartoons, I mean, I thought that was pretty cool. So, it's Beetlejuice, you can't go wrong with that. This next one, Frank Caliendo, a very funny comedian who did the Fox NFL Sunday stuff, the Late Show, David Letterman spoofs, and he could do George W. Bush, Al Pacino, Bill Clinton, Dave Letterman, Jay Leno, I didn't already say that. John Madden. This is his first actual DVD special, as far as, well, I should say first special, but it was on TBS, televised special, while the other stuff that he's come out with was more like independent comedian stand-up stuff. This is actually a special TV edition. But, yeah, it's pretty good. It's really funny. You know, it comes in a widescreen format, which everything's in widescreen now. And, yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. Very funny stuff. Very funny. Let's see what we're doing for time here. I wish I had a clock here that would actually, or a timer. I have about 5 minutes left, so I think I'll be able to get through these last few. This next one, or these next three, I should say, is kind of a, well, kind of a cool little collection here that I can definitely say I'm proud of, no matter what. I bought this earlier this summer from Target, and I'm talking about the 3-pack of the John Candy classics that have been released on DVD separately, but they put them together in a 3-pack, which I think is nice. The packaging is all nice. I have the Crocodile Dundee feature like this too, and the Naked Gun, and it has movies like Once Upon a Crime, Canadian Bacon, and Delirious. Very good stuff. Now these ones I got from Columbia House, and I'm actually going to be getting a few more, so when I get the rest of what I think I got about another 10 or 11 movies coming. But these I got because I'm a huge Bill Murray fan, like I said. He was one of the greatest actors next to Michael J. Fox, you know. And I'm talking classic Bill Murray, not today's Bill Murray. I mean, he's okay. He's just really, really old. But the fact that he's going to be doing a role or in the Ghostbuster video game, which has been confirmed, and I saw the trailer for it now that YouTube's got HD and all that stuff. I'm talking about the movie that he did, Mad Dog and Glory. I have not seen this, so I don't really know what it's about, but it's with him, Robert De Niro, and Uma Thurman. So I can't wait to check that out. Another one that I got, a movie I don't know if anybody really has ever seen before, was called The Razor's Edge. Another Bill Murray classic. Talks about how he's trying to find himself, and it takes place after World War One. So, but it's from 1984. It's around the time when Ghostbusters was being released. So, should be good to see. And we're getting down to wire. Those other two movies that I will be having. Hold on here. I'm gonna have to let it go. the phone's ringing. These next two movies or whatever, I'm waiting for the other two to come from Columbia House, but I got the National Lampoon's Vacation and National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. Definitely a classic no matter what. And this is a classic too. The other ones I'm waiting for is European Vacation and Vegas Vacation. And then I'll have the whole series. So, anyway, that is a quick look at my DVDs for now. And like I said, if I do any more, I'll definitely let you know or get any more. But I guess that's all I have to say. If you tune in after this video, I am going to be making another video, but it's more like a little rant or whatever, talking about some upcoming things and acknowledging some of the people that, 2008's almost done. And I want to take some time to acknowledge some people that I, have enjoyed watching on YouTube this year. So hopefully you'll stick around for that. But until then, I'm Frankie Slauson, and thanks for enjoying my DVD update. See you later.